because of the corona lockdown, we're not able to travel, so I will show you some of the coolest places I've been to in the past. In this episode, we explore some decommissioned French naval ships. Near the coast in Brittany, you can find a ship cemetery where also Navy ships have a last resting place before getting scrapped. I went here many times between 2011 and 2016 and spent a few weeks on them in total. In the next episode, we take a look inside a famous cruiser Le Colbert and some other ships. But first, we explore two other ships called the Aconit and the Duguay-Trouin, which entered the ship cemetery in November 2014. The Duguay-Trouin is a frigate and specialized in anti-submarine warfare, but it also has anti-aircraft and anti-surface armament. She served between 1975 and 1999 and was named after the famous pirate of the 17th century, René Duguay-Trouin. The ship had a total crew of 300 people. The Aconit was a unique frigate built for the French Navy during the Cold War, which served from 1973 to 1997. She was named after the corvette Aconit, who fought in the Free French Naval Forces during the Second World War. The ship had a crew of 232 people. In the beginning of 2015, we went to pioneer these ships. No explorer had entered these ships before. From our previous experiences, we learned that it was better to use another point of entry to get into the water. Our previous point was a steep and narrow path downhill, which ended in a rocky and muddy area. All our rubber boats got ripped. From this point, you can get easily in the water. The only disadvantage is that it's a lot further. We take a telescope ladder because we have no clue how we will get onto these ships. I calculated that the height to cover is about 4 or 5 meters, 12 to 15 feet high. One last tourist snap before we set sail. We don't take our expensive equipment with us this time, in case it goes wrong. The water is pretty calm at this point, luckily, because we have to paddle a mile to get to these ships.
Over the half. Het leeft nog steeds. Maar ik ben ook nog droog.
I check carefully if it's doable to climb the chain.
Schoenen. ik ben erop. Ik even kijken.
I quickly scout both ships to see if there is a possible entry. I don't take too much time to avoid we get seen. Most easy entrances turn out to be welded. One of the ships has a few potential entrances, and the other one looks tight shut. Time for the second run. We did some shopping and got ourselves a disposable barbecue, meat and drinks. We also take a sleeping bag, because we will spend the night in these ships. We notice the current is getting stronger. It costs us a lot of effort to get to these ships again. At this point you can see how strong the current is. It was still nothing compared to the next day, when we had to leave in the early morning.
Zoveel mogelijk er tegenaan liggen. Nog steeds met de voet één hoger. Wacht, oh. Daar staat, ja, daar. Wat zei je? Niet? Moet ik in hoger, moet je zo. Ja, maar het wordt droger dadelijk wel, hè.
I have to convince Koen to climb the slippery chain. It almost goes wrong. Luckily, he gets on the ship dry. With a grappling hook, we lift all the gear onto the ship.
Ja, kleurend. Ja, doe maar eens vast.
Heel big boss.
Ja? Oh, ik had een slapende voet. Dat is kut. High five, dansje.
The next step is to hide the boat, in case the naval police or the navy comes by, to check if there's nobody on the ships. This happens pretty frequently.
Ja,
One of my possible entries turned out to be a dead end. Luckily, there are many possibilities to enter the ship. Every hole could be an entrance.
Deze kant. We kunnen ook even via die kant en dan. Ja, maar via de andere kant moeten we dadelijk eventjes kijken. Even kijken of het hier was of daar was. Er is ook een deksel wat open kan hier. Dat is hier om te kijken. Ik ga even terug naar die andere kant, hè.
Luckily, the last possible entry leads into the ship.
Going. Going.
Inside, you can walk for hours. Every staircase leads to another compartment.
Yeah.
It's cold and dark, and you can smell the oil and diesel inside these vessels.
Zo, dit is naar buiten gaan ofzo. Ik zie hier een tang zitten. Ik ga zo met z'n tief ofzo. Ik zou het even moeten doen. Dat zijn er wel. Dat is dikke last, kijk. Zie dat? Dan ga ik misschien naar buiten doen dit. Ik heb een doel daar eens. Moeten gaan, dus er is niets. Je komt er vandaan, hè, Koen? Koen? Colbert was een stuk makkelijker. Als je vaak weer Jelle Boek door de vat. Ja, dus. Ja, dat is weer natuurlijk. Ben je daar ook al helemaal geweest aan het einde? Ah, oké, okay, moet je gewoon eens omlaag en kijken of we ergens omhoog gaan kunnen. Ik denk dat je hier de machinekamer hebt. Ah, hier dit. Hier zitten we even goed. Ja, hier is klaslocaties, dat zie ik hier. Bar hier gewoon, man. Ja. De keuken, hè? Ja. De kitchen. Barbecue meister. Gezocht. Gigantisch daar van binnen, hè, die dingen. Access interdit, niet voor ons, wat is dat? Hey Koen? 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 Waar? Nog een keer. Weet je wat we misschien moeten doen? De spullen even halen tot hier. Nee, dat is ook zo vet te klein, hè? Dat is dik wel zelf. Maar ik wil daar even een statief halen voor die brug. Ja. Oké, hier weer checken. Wat zit er in de kisten? Ja, ja, er zijn zeker 300-400 man op, hè, het schip. Wie zit het hier? Ah, nou, kijk eens. Waar was het? Engeland? Zeker dat hier nog niemand binnen is geweest met de Nederlandsvlag. Nee. Ik denk dat hier nog niemand geweest is sinds hier liggen. Of die ingang heb ik echt moeten maken. Ik heb dichtgehoest. vast hier. Waar zijn klokken? Zitten hier. Ik had de vorige keer gewoon op zo'n ding geslapen als dit hier. Lekker hè? Hier een matje van ons. Hey. Laat slaap zijn. Die radarruimte. Ik heb daar weer gekeken op die map hè. Nou, hier is een flinke. Dat is gewoon. Dit is officier, denk ik wel later. Is dat een stuk? Goed zo. Ja, of je dit goed of je dit niet hè. De zaal is hier. Harder. Ja. Dan zijn we de poort nog, hè? Ja, hier is een land hier. Precies zoals die andere lekker dan. Als je dit stukje ziet.
After exploring the ships, the weather suddenly changes. It's storming. We have a barbecue in the biggest room inside the ship. And after that, we turn it into a little fire. It's getting dark. And suddenly we hear a voice through a megaphone, but we can't understand what they are saying. Through some small chinks and holes, we see a patrol light. It's probably the naval police or the navy. We extinguish the fire. The only benefit is that they probably can't get onto the ships now. The next morning, we leave as early as possible to avoid getting into trouble. It's still storming and we can paddle only with the current. We get on land at another point. Wet and covered in mud, we have to walk back for many miles. After some hours, we luckily meet a local resident who takes us back to our car. It was quite an adventure.
Dingen liggen er nog.
No, dat was even spannend, hè?
Ja, zeg wel.
A year later, I return to these ships for the TV series Exitus. In these series, I visit abandoned places to bring them back alive with stop motion technique.
Together with Jeroen, another stop motion animator.
Because I already knew how to get onto and inside the ships, and the weather was nice, it was a lot more convenient this time. Seagulls are breeding now, so when we walk outside, we get attacked.
Pak die bezem.
This little hole was the only entrance inside the Aconit. It took me hours and hours to find it during my first visit.
Get on here, darling.
Good to be back, huh? De brug. Ah, je komt een beetje licht naar binnen.
This is the bridge on the Aconit. All windows have been welded, and inside it's pitch black almost everywhere. This is the bridge on the Duguay-Trouin, where the windows are not welded shut.
Mm-hmm. Back to the bin.
Stop motion videos are images put together at high speed, so it looks like a video. 25 pictures have to be taken and everything has to be moved 25 times to get 1 second of video. It's a time-consuming process. While we explore the ship, we look closely for things we can move and animate. Here are a few shots of the end result.
Pasta und Pesto.
Kommt gut.
Also this time, we spend the night on the ship. If you want to see the whole episode, which is in Dutch, I've put a link in the description. Because the footage is old and shaky, I added a lot of pictures for you, to get a good idea how the ship looked like. you like the pictures, you'll also like the books which I published. They cover the coolest locations I have been to in the past 13 years.